Okay guys, hey and welcome to the Starbreeze stream about the workshop in Payday 2. It's me, Overkill Joachim, sitting here with Overkill Tobbe.
Hello everyone.
Overkill Tobbe, or as I'm gonna call him, Tobbe, will take questions. We'll take questions from you guys in the chat, and I will go through all the steps we need to do to make a skin from scratch. So, let's start by opening Photoshop CS2. Photoshop CS2 is free. You found a link somewhere. And you can just use it. Otherwise, you can use GIMP and other software that can open an alpha channel and have channels and can save in Targa. So let's start by opening up this file. Let's see where I got it. I got it there somewhere. Here we go. The base gradient template, as you've seen before. The base gradient is for setting a color to a material. You can also do a bunch of stuff with it, as you probably seen in the manual. Here you have the diffuse group. If you go down to gradients, you have all different materials. You can take a look at this first. All these different colors represent a material at the weapon you are gonna skin. So you have metal, you have plastic, you have wood, secondary metal, cloth, or detail. Depending on how the UV is set up on the weapon itself, both secondary metal and metal could be the primary and most used material on the weapon. It's not necessarily the first metal that is the main metal. So it could also be the secondary metal. Therefore, you can save out these material borders and use it to check that out. We can do that. We can take all these layers, delete them, save as a target. We save it on the desktop for now. Save. You always save 32 bits and uncompressed. Let's save it down. Can you hear me properly? Otherwise you have to write to Tobbe and tell him to raise my volume. Oh, let's see. I prepared this little folder here where I will put it. Let's go into the game and see. So, I've prepared this M308 rifle, where you go to, we can go from the beginning actually. If you want to work with the workshop, you go to options, you have this workshop button that actually enables you to use the workshop. Do you have a question, Tobbe?
Yeah, I have a question here from the Holy Lord Gaben. How much can we change the weapons? The legendary skins sometimes completely change the weapon, and I was wondering how much we could do while making skins.
You can change literally anything you want on the skins. You won't be able to do what we've done and own unique modifications, mods that you can put on the skins. We will, as we do the community save, we will choose one of your skins to be the legendary skin, but we will still make the 3D model, the modification that will be applied to the legendary skin. Let's continue on. I prepared this M308 rifle. So here it is. What you do, what I already done, is press new skin, then you enter ID. I already done that to prepare, as you've seen before, this folder. When you press new skin in your Payday 2 folder, it creates a workshop and a folder. Here's a previous skin I did, and this is for the M308. I know that because it's the last one made. Here was also where I put the new gradient we made, the one that will show us where the materials is. So let's move on. Here we go. Here we can see that the primarily used color for metal would be the green one. And you have the orange one, the red one, and the pink one that's being used. You can also see, if we zoom in a bit, there you have what we call the tiny. You see those green screws here? These are the tiny area. So, you can do however you want with your workflow. One thing you could do is take a screenshot of this, and so you have a reference if you want to do that. But let's continue out again to Photoshop and continue our little tutorial. Do you want to save changes? No.
I have a couple of questions here.
Yes.
Let's start at the top here. We have Samuel Toe. Can we use screens right now before they are approved in the workshop?
No, not at the moment. We are looking looking to create a solution for you guys where you can actually test it in a local environment. When I say environment, I don't need know how yet, if it would be the safe house or a special test level, but you won't be using be able to use it on all levels.
Can you add effects? Asks PipJar.
Do you mean particle effects? Then the answer would be no, if you're referring to like the Dota workshop. No, we won't be able to do that.
I think this one is sort of combined here. It's Samanses.
Okay.
246. Can I put? Can you put in carvings?
If you refer to the skin cartel, maybe in the CS:GO skin. It's not actual carvings. It's made in Photoshop by tweaking lights and how you create the skin. But no, you cannot carve in the UV, and you cannot create a normal map. What you can use is the tools we're going to show you, but you cannot alter the model in any way.
Marco TLA asks, is the community safe? Will the community itself use a drill or not?
All saves is drill free from update 100, isn't it, Tom?
Yeah, 100. And the last questions I pulled out was Keshat, will this workshop be free to use?
Yes, it's open for everyone. So,
and Bambino calls you a Windows 10 peasant, by the way.
Oh, I'm a peasant?
Yes, you are.
Oh, thank you. So let's continue. We go back and take the base gradient. So what we're going to do now is we're going to make a skin together. So as I started with before, we have the diffuse group, the upper gradients, and we have the ordinary gradients. We will talk about the upper gradients later. We start with the gradients. So here you have the first color, the red one, then you have we have the orange one, we have the green one. That green one, I guess, was the one we saw most in the picture, wasn't it, Tobbe, on the weapon?
Yeah, absolutely.
This green one, yeah.
So I like that you point with your finger, yeah. That's very helpful.
Yeah, they see when I point with the finger. So that would refer to plastic, right? So let's go into plastic. We see a few different layers here, where this one would be the wear and tear. If you follow my mouse here, it's here you start with no wear and tear in this material, and it goes like this, and here is the worst wear and tear. So I could actually create different colors or different faces in each material for the wear and tear. On this angle, on the other side, if I create a gradient, would be when you turn the weapon. I will show you more about this later, but it creates a chroma effect. So if I have red here and blue here, and I turn the weapon in a different angle, it would go slowly from red to blue. If you do that too sharp, it's gonna have some strange effects. It's gonna look like a mirror. I can't really explain it, but you need to gradient it to look really good.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So, to move on.
You can have sharp gradients for a sharper effect, but yes, some gradient would probably be the best.
So here we have the solid color that will switch. No, that's the wrong one. Here is the right one, right? That will switch the color on that particular green we saw. That would be the plastic material. So let's say we want to make a pretty skin color. Skin, maybe? What do you say about that, Tobbe? Should we make a skin colored?
Oh yeah, that sounds absolutely dreadful.
So, I change this one. I will change this metal here to also have some nasty skin color. Let's see. Yeah, that seems a lot Barbie skin. As you can see here, there's a gradient here that that goes from up and down over the metal color. That is put there to create a sense of a metal feeling into the pattern. Just for your information, why that gradient is there. Let's make it more plastic and actually remove that one. Let's go back and see. Now we took metal, plastic. We go to secondary metal, we take that solid color, we continue with our skin colored horrible, horrible theme. So let's
perhaps
start.
You should use something that Tobbe. Actually looks a little bit nice.
Tobbe, I think this color is about you. So there we go.
Okay, yeah.
Mm. Yeah. We also had, we had no blue in it. That was the details, that green, I would say. No. Let's count. So we have metal, plastic, wood rubber, secondary metal, cloth in this case, as we saw, you remember, it was the little screws. So I think we're fine here. We can make the rest black, or we could actually just save it out and try it out at first to see how it works. So I will close that one down, so we have this. Save as desktop. We save it as skin B grab. And remember, it needs to be a targa. It needs to have alpha channels clicked in. 32 bits uncompressed.
You want to take a few questions?
We can take a few questions.
Yeah. So Godspeed version 2. Is asking if this will be PC exclusive.
Yes, it will be, because it needs to go through Steam, and you don't have a Steam on console. So yes, it will be PC exclusive.
Netog100 asks if the creators will be paid.
No, they will not be paid, since we removed all income from the saves. We will not then pay the skin creators either. We are looking at maybe creating a mask that will be exclusive to all creators, maybe in the future, and do something cool.
Next question is, can you make like CSGO skin for any weapon in Payday? That was from the Shield 313.
Can you take that question again?
Yeah, the question was basically, can you make skins for any weapon in Payday 2?
Not now. For the moment, they are. For the moment, we have about 40 weapons that are done, that have a good UV UV2 map. It's all about. We need to adjust the weapons to fit this system, and it's not entirely done with all weapons. But to the next update we will do with the workshop, big update, we will have all weapons done.
Then we have, can you apply dynamic textures for things like reflective gold materials? That was from Dreamer's Speedruns.
Yes, I'm I'm going to be sincere now, and I'm not an artist. I've learned the system, and I'm not entirely sure how you would create a gold material, but I know it's doable.
I think everyone will see very soon that you're not an artist.
Yes, but I've seen some of our artists create real cool chroma effects and glassed like silver effects on weapons, so I would guess that you can create the gold effect as well.
What kind of modeling software is used to make the weapons in Payday 2? That was from Reddington?
I think it's Maya, actually. Yes.
And ZBrush.
Yeah.
Noobrage92 asks, can we have an option to flip mirror patterns on the side of the gun?
We can absolutely ask for that and see what our programmer says. Yes. So please make a post in the forum and we will look into it.
The last question that I pulled out for this time was from PP Jargon. Can we create our own materials?
No. Those materials you have, that is listed, that I showed you, the different colors, are those materials that exist. And this is set in code, so you cannot change this.
Oh, and Samuel Tao, since I got bashed for pronouncing his name wrong, asked you to don't save things on your desktop. That's just bad practice. Come on.
Mm. As I said, I'm not an artist, so I will keep my bad practices. Practice. So here we go. I put in the new file we made, the skin B grad, you remember, into the file here. So let's see. We go into Payday 2 again. In this folder, you remember, was the folder for the M308. Let's go to the M308, go to edit skin, go to the base skin. And there we go, our skin gun.
You as need you to change those colors, I mean, come on.
I think it's beautiful. As you can see, the colors of the skin is not entirely as we painted them. They have some glossiness, they have some specular that we need to go through. It's a cube map intensity, gloss, and specular map. The specular map is what you see here. You see those scratches here? The specular is how much, let's see, how much light is taken up in these scratches or fat. The gloss is how, you have to correct me here if I'm wrong, Tobbe, yeah, but yes. The gloss would be how flat the light goes over this surface, or if it's a pinned a strong light, as you can see on this edge here.
Yeah, the gloss here is the more sharp the light would be, yeah, sort of.
So then we have the last channel that we're going to talk about would be this. No, I think we talked about all. Yes, we have the cube map intensity. The cube map intensity is how much reflection from the outer world that would be taken into the gun when light falls upon it. Was that correct, Olle?
Yes, close enough. I mean, as most of you know, there is a cube map that is what you see in reflections of all reflective materials in the game, and the cube map intensity obviously shows controls how much that cube map you see in the gun itself, in the specific material.
Yes, right. So let's go out again. We don't want to save the changes. We go back. I think I missed one material, and that's why we are a bit out here. So let's open this up again. And we take the first material there. Let's see. No, it would be that material. Let's see, plastic gradient for solid color, right? That's where I missed, so let's take that one and do it pretty solid color as well. Now let's talk about the upper gradients. The upper gradients do control different stuff, as we talked about a bit. The red channel and the green control cube map intensity and gloss. So you have one here, the red one. That goes from 0, as you can see here, 0, 0, 0. That's black. You have white, 255. 0 means that it's turned off the cube map intensity, and 255 is maximum. So if we would take the middle on the cube map, pretty low on the cube map intensity there, and the gloss would be a bit lower as well, it would be more like hard, soft plastic that doesn't take up light that good.
Yeah.
Then you have the alpha channel for each. If you do alpha channel on these up here, the 6 pixels we're talking about, you're actually changing the specular of the material, how well it takes up light in scratches and fat and grease and stuff like we talked about. If you change the alpha for the whole base gradient, and if you turn that off, you will turn off that it that the pattern is visible on these materials.
Exactly. Yeah.
And if it's total on, the pattern will be applied on these materials. So if we take like the let's see, the alpha we have here, metal we have there, it's a solid color and it's white. That means on metal it will be fully on. That will say it will take the pattern. If I would go into this one here and turn it into black, this material will never have a pattern on it because the opacity
is absolutely
exactly
So then that is a way to effectively turn off the pattern on, say, all plastic materials, all plastic parts of the gun. So for example, if you have a stock that's both metal and plastic, and you want the pattern to only appear on the metal parts, this is how you would do that.
Cool. Okay, let's move on. We have this base gradient. We're satisfied with that. So we will save it as it is. Boom. Close it down. Close that down. We've seen that in games, so we know approx on how it looks. Should we move on to making a pattern, or you want to go through a few questions?
A few questions, yeah. I have a new list here.
Okay.
We start with Gamer Mita, I think.
Yes.
Will there be an option to make skins without Photoshop?
There is an option. You can make it with any software you want, as long as it can handle channels.
Yeah, alpha channels, and be able to edit both the RGB and the R, the G, and the B channels.
Yeah, so that would be GimpWorks.
Yeah,
it's a free one.
Absolutely.
I actually don't know all the software, so I can't answer you which one that works. But it does work as long as you can.
I think there's
work with channels.
A web page called like alternative.com that you can say like I want alternatives for GIMP or Photoshop or something. Yeah. Can we make transparent colors? What I think Malutra means here is, can we make the base color, the base texture of the weapon shine through the skin? And no, we cannot do that.
Yeah, probably that. Or if you mean, if you have a base gradient and you want to apply a pattern, and we talked about that alpha channel material, if you want that to be blue, you have a red background, you can make that half opacity by have half alpha channel.
Yeah, you can make the pattern semi-transparent or fully transparent,
but the base gradient will always be a color. But if you change the gloss and the specular map and the cube map intensity, if you play around with those top controllers, you can make it look really shiny or really matte. No, what to call it, matte.
Yeah. Matte. Gabman250 asked, will we be able to make weapon models for the game?
Who knows what happens in the future? For now, no. We're not looking looking at it for the moment, but who knows?
Enly1 asks, will there be custom effects for the weapon similar to the Plague Doctor mask?
No, Not at the moment, no.
Golden Magikarp Gaming ask, can we draw on skins?
Like in CSGO, when you draw on the UV texture, no.
There is a workaround, though.
There is a workaround. What you do instead is that you use stickers, and you create either one that covers the weapon, or if the weapon is too big, you actually use like two or three stickers, as we've seen on the Dragon Flamethrower we have. We have a very talented artist, Max, who did that sticker. Then we actually, on that weapon, it's actually two stickers applied that, two stickers that you just have to like puzzle on the gun to make it look good.
Where was it? Draw skin, yeah. The Shield 313 again. Can you make skins with pictures and patterns? That was actually the same question.
Yeah.
So we're going to go through patterns and stickers later.
Yeah.
Athen 37, is the preview quality fixed? I think what they're referring to there is the preview quality slider in the editor.
Yep.
That one was actually broken in the beta, so it didn't actually work. It works now.
Okay, good. Nice.
Danbox asks, how will it be decided which skin makes it into the community safe? Will it be done with the community's vote, or will Overkill Strawberries decide on that or something else?
We will take in consider all the votes on the skins, of course. But at the finishing point, it's going to be us that decides, because we also need to check the files that get sent in, that they look good, work good, and that we can work with them. Because at the end, all you guys see is the screenshot someone sends. It may not even contain real files.
And then the last for this list was Zurex 7620.
Yeah.
Do you upload the weapons on? How do you upload the weapons under the workshop?
We will go through that.
Yes.
Now I will continue doing a pattern. So I will do the maximum width and height. That will be 1024 and 22 in resolution. So let's make a pattern, Tobbe.
Absolutely.
Are you good at drawing?
Yes, that's why I think it would be hilarious if you did it.
Okay, you're lying.
Yeah.
So imagine we want maybe to have a blue something. We want a blue something.
Yeah, because that will go great with our color scheme.
Yeah. So let's make a blue ball with...
You call that a ball?
Yeah, you know.
I mean, you have a tool for circles, like right up there. Come on now.
No, but it needs to be hand-painted. Otherwise, you know, it's not really craftsmanship.
You have to feel real, okay.
Yeah. So I actually did a little mistake here. I'm just going to do like that.
Blue Fox asks if we can show more of the chrome effect and metal parts on the gun.
Yes, I will try to. I will actually try to do a chroma effect for you. I will redo this now because I will have transparent background here. So, we took red here, a little bit here.
I just want to point out that the transparent background is not actually necessary, it just makes it easier.
I will show you a little trick if you want to do a tileable. It's called offset. A lot of people know about it, some don't. I made it two duplicates of the layer with a transparent background here. I'll turn that off. I take this one, the highest up one. I go to other. I do an offset. Since I have a 1024 size, I want to do this on half size. So this is 512, 512. If my file size would be 512, these offsets need to be on 256. You put it on wraparound, press OK. Then you can take this layer up again. And there you have a tileable pattern that could be used.
Only one just asked, is this art? And no, it isn't. It's horrible. It's horrible.
It's
absolutely horrible.
It's a Picasso.
Yeah. Don't quit your day job.
No. So now, when we have a beautiful pattern, we will actually start making the real pattern as the file needs to look for the system to actually, you know, be able to read it. So I will make, this is different on different Photoshop and GIMP, but I will do it as it works in Photoshop. I create three different groups. I name one R, one G, one B. I double click the map. Here we have the channels, as you can see. So I turn off G and B. So everything in here is only on the red channel. On G here, we turn do the same, but for G.
Adam 2 says, it's very cute watching Joachim draw.
Oh, thank you, Adam.
Yeah, you have one fan. Good job.
One fan. So now we have one for each channel here. So in the pattern, you have four channels that needs to be in the file for it to work. Red channel is opacity. You have the green channel, that's the color lookup. You have the gloss in the blue channel and specular on the alpha channel.
Absolutely, yeah.
As usual, as everything in the system, 0, that is black, is turned off, and 255, that's white, is turned on. So let's make the first one. We make the opacity. So I don't want these areas to be seen in the pattern. It should be fully transparent. So what I do is I control click here and I mark everything. Here. I will paint it, let's see, black, because it will be seen, right? Not transparent, it will be seen. So let's paint it black. Toby just hates me now because I don't use layer masks, but I'm too lazy. Then I take select inverse. And these areas now that we paint, the white area, is the areas that is going to be transparent.
Yes, Andy, I would love a heist where we steal Joachim's artwork. That would be hilarious.
Please don't do that.
Oh, yes,
it's the next Picasso. So we have the first done, right? I can turn that off for better visibility now. Okay. Now we're going to do the color lookup. What I usually do is actually just like this. I just turn down the saturation. That was not a good choice on this particular one. Let's see. What we could do is, let's see if this works. No. Should we do it in grayscale?
Sorry, what?
We just do the black and white one. Do you know where that is, Toba?
The black and white one?
With the adjustments.
Yeah, why just not use the like hue and saturation? Yeah.
Didn't want me to. It's the same color.
That's your fault. I mean, switch the colors around then.
Yeah, we can switch the colors around.
What he's trying to get here is he's trying to get them to be different values.
Exactly.
So you're gonna have to change the saturation.
I think that would work. That would work.
No, lightness. Yes. Okay. There we go.
There we go. Now we have three different values here. So, in the lookup, the color lookup here. Let's see. In the color lookup, you need to check here. If you look at this one, this is 127. This is 58. And the last one in here is 141. These number you need to write down because we will use them in the pattern gradient later. So 141, 127, 58. I will now put that one in the green. I just realized that we actually made a mistake with this one.
I was just waiting for you to see how long it would take you to figure that out.
And it's actually the opposite, isn't it, Tobbe?
Yes, it is.
Oh, you're just... Now it's red here, because it's in the red channel. If I put it out here, it will not be red. So, adjustment.
Invert.
Yeah. Exactly. So, we put it in the red again. We have this one in the green. So, we're done with two channels. Two out of four, right?
Two out of four, yeah.
Two out of four. So, the blue one is the specular. Can you tell them what the specular did again?
The specular is how much... Well, the sharpness of the light coming in, basically, if you want something really, well, specular, so to speak. It's very, It's a little bit hard to explain.
Yeah,
without
the one with the scratches and the fat that it picks up from a map.
Oh,
the specular map.
Sorry. So, yeah, you're absolutely correct. I'm mixing stuff up here. So the specular is, well, each weapon has something called a specular map. And in the specular map, we have dust, scratches, and imperfections in the rifle. And this is how, this will control how much of that map will come through the rifle. So not very specular will look clean. And very specular would look very dirty and very scratched.
And that is the alpha shell.
Yes, that is the alpha channel.
That is the alpha channel. So the alpha channel you create by doing a new channel in channels. Here I have the alpha channels. My way of doing it is that I'm actually just taking a one I did here. Control A, Control C, go into the alpha channel. Control V, turn it off again. Now it's done. It's also the same with the blue channel, is the gloss, the one we talked about before, how much light it receives. If the light is, you remember we talked about the edge, if it's a hard light or if it flattens out over the area. And that is something that actually defines what material it is. So I'll take this one in here and it should look like this when everything's turned on. This one I can keep for reference if I want, just to remember what colors I want, or I can, you know, improvise it later. But let's save this one out.
So I got a question here. Can we get rid of scratches and stuff like that?
No.
Well, not really, but you can turn down the effect of them through that channel.
Yes, through that channel. But you can't get rid of them because they're built in a normal map in the weapon.
That was Godspeed that asks that. Then we have YOLO Swag Mister.
Mm.
And Alti basically asks the same question here. It's, can we put logos of Payday 2 or other games onto the skin? Or can we, what about Overkill intellectual properties? Actually, existing logos and patterns usable in your skin creations?
I will have to check that first if the community is allowed to use our IP things like logos and stuff onto the actual skins. So I will answer that later on the workshop forum.
I can say right now that obviously other games,
other companies, you can't bring Coca-Cola, for example. So let's make the pattern gradient.
Yes.
256, 256, 72 would be the required size of the pattern gradient.
Yes. And do you want to explain why that is?
Why the exact size? Because it measures the color lookup for the exact amount of pixels.
Yeah. So when he said earlier that you needed to remember the values of the different colors, it's because we're going to color that area of this map in different colors. If you have a lot more values or a gradient in your pattern, then you can use a gradient in the pattern gradient to give a fuller range of colors.
Exactly. So you remember the numbers? I don't. Tobbe, did you write it down?
Yes.
You did write it down.
I did.
You have
of
it
course.
Here.
Yeah.
So
because I knew you wouldn't remember it.
If you use this Control R, shows you the what's it called, like the measurement tool.
Yes.
Don't know the word. Rulers is the word.
Yes, rulers would be the.
You can take that one to set it to zero from the corner. So you see it's 256 out here. So every point, if you remember, the grayscale is to 255. So every one is 1.0003 or something like that. So what you could do now is if we find the first, we do a new layer actually.
We also have a question why you would put. Nipples on your gun.
What? It's not nipples.
I actually think it looks more like donuts.
It's Monet flowers. Come on. So,
are you sure you don't want to make something actually interesting to look at? I mean, spark effect something. Come on.
I made a new layer now here. So the first number we had for one color was 58. So let's see, we have 58 about here. I will make a little dot. That's why I made a new layer. We have 58 would be around there.
I have a question from Luna Radian.
Yeah. Is it Luna from Harry Potter?
Spell the same.
Okay.
If there's a, if there will be an animation tool, and I'm assuming for the skins, no.
No.
No, there will be.
Then we have 127 and 141. They were very close to each other, so that would be about here. So, as you see, I made a layer on top of the other layer. Let's start working with the other layer here. So, if I just want three colors on this base gradient here, I can only do like this. Boom. We paint that with, what should we say? What color do you want, Tobbe? Blue?
Yes, blue.
Boom.
Definitely blue.
Then we take the next area. To there.
White, maybe?
Nah.
Alright, no.
You're so boring.
Really?
Yeah, I love this color. Mm-hmm. Here we go. And then we go with the last one. Here is where one of the chroma effects can come in. There we go. Now I can throw the dot layer away. Boom.
Got a question.
So if
here
I did.
That I missed actually, it was about new weapons. If when we release new DLCs or weapon packs, will they automatically be added to the list of weapons?
Yes, it may take some time, so maybe not right on the update, but yes, all weapons
and
will
also
be in the workshop.
Then we perhaps would say something about older weapons that are not on the list.
Yeah, I think we already told them, but all weapons will be available from the next big update. I can't say when it's gonna be ready exactly, but it's coming. So, the pattern gradient now is, you remember the first dot was 58 or something, it would be around here. So, that would mean this becomes blue. So, in this one, the green one, you have that grayscale, you remember the grayscale we made? The 58 one, I guess it's that one, would be the color blue. One of the others, which one it now was, would be green and purple. So let's save this one, the pattern gradient. Same here, you save it as a target, like all other files. We save it on desktop as, what should we name it, PatGrad maybe? Sounds good. PatGrad. Save. Here's what the interesting thing, someone talked about the chroma effect, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, if I would do like this, I put on the, what's it called, quick mask, I think. I take the gradient tool. And I go from something like here to here. Oh no, I got the wrong, let's see. That gradient tool. So. What I do now is applying a quick mask that's pretty feathered. If you look here, it goes from here, but if I pull it, it's not only here the line goes, it's feathered, so it will actually fade over the whole one. As you see, it's fading. So if I want to create a chroma effect, I can now change the U a bit, like that, and we raise the saturation a bit and the lightness. So what happens now is in a specific angle of this pattern it will be this color, and the more you angle the weapon the more blue it gets. And
actually the more you angle away from you, so the top of the pattern will be looking straight at it, basically an angle of zero between your viewing angle, and the greater the further down.
Actually let's save it like this so you can see what we're talking about. We go like that, PatGrad to save desktop, or we replace it. Yes, we have no shame. We don't work with source files, do we, Tobbe?
Well, you don't, because...
No, not me, at least.
Yeah. But on the other hand, you save stuff to the desktop.
And this one,
desktop,
so. Gonna be green, red, blue.
I have a couple of questions here.
Yeah, I will save this file for the, and we will go into the editor. You can ask questions.
Yeah. Well, Tom DaFunk,
yes,
I think you're supposed to pronounce it like that, asks if UVs will be available for bases for creating patterns or something like that.
No.
Anarchy Blues
Since let me elaborate on that. Since our system is kind of sensitive, we won't distribute the normal map, the spec map, or the UV. We also actually have two UVs for the system to work.
Then we have, let's see here, his name was Anarchy Blues. Will you ever be able enable proper quality models in the game, like in the menu? And the menu is using the first person models, meaning you can see, so you see the weapon really nice. It's the same weapon model that you use, that you see yourself holding. They're very expensive, so having them on all four characters would be very costly.
Yes.
Will there be simpler ways? You've six. We ask, will there be simpler ways to make skins there for people that are not that experienced?
No, unfortunately not. We're looking for a way to maybe have the base skin applied on the weapon, that you can go into the editor and you see the weapon as you see it in game now with the base skins, and that you can apply stickers or only patterns if you think the base gradient is kind of advanced.
Yeah, it's something we look into, yeah.
It will not be as easy as the CSGO, some of the functions in CSGO workshop, for example.
Yeah. Golden Magikarp Gaming asked, will there be some skins made by Overkill?
Yes.
Going forward,
we will continue doing safes, but we will make less safes. And what we want to see is that it comes more safes from the community than from us. But that special occasion, from here to there, yes, we will make skins.
Can we customize melee weapons?
Same answer that. Maybe in the future, who knows? Nothing we have planned yet, but who knows?
I just wanted to add to this question about simpler ways to make skins, that we already know that it will be coming video tutorials and stuff like that to help people, and you will easier find Photoshop tutorials, GIMP tutorials, all kinds of tutorials. Yeah.
We already have two video tutorials that are linked in my announcement. It's actually three video tutorials, I think, AJ Valentine from Last Bullet. I actually looked them through yesterday night, and they're pretty good. It's actually everything I'm doing now, but they're on videos on YouTube, so it's really good to check out if you need a reference point.
Oh, someone just said it's very loud. Is it really loud for everyone else? Just
it could be me. I'm moving the mic away a bit. So, let's see. Let's continue here. So, let's see if I did everything correct here. We added skin, the base skin. You remember we need a base gradient. Here we go. We have a pattern gradient, you remember that? The PatGrad 2. And then we go to the pattern.
Oh, it's the game audio that's loud.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Quick the auto here and take away the audio.
Sorry, no.
Yeah, it was just when you started.
Sorry,
up. It's,
guys.
It's the intro to the game.
I don't have a sound on, so I can't hear it myself. Where's the sound? Really? Really low. There we go. So,
the intro to the game is not the same thing.
Let's see our Monet flower, as you also called the tit, if it works out good. So, the base skin, remember it was named Skin B Grad. Then we take the Pat Grad 2 and the pattern. If we take down the pattern scale, you obviously see I did something really wrong here. Because
yes,
it's one color on it.
I take no responsibility there. I was reading the chat at that point.
Yeah, I was kind of unfocused. Do you have any idea what we did wrong?
Well, I would have to look at the... It looks like...
Let's see. Let's go up. God damn it.
While you're doing that, don't quit out the game. Because now the intro is going to play again and it's going to be really loud.
No, it took away all the volume on the game.
Doesn't work.
Really?
No. Are there any plans to collaborate with skin authors on making legendary skins? Asks Adam too.
Yes, as I said before, we are gonna take the skin from the community when we do that. The legendary skin. And then we're gonna communicate with them on what we can do. It's also dependent on what time we have and everything. But we will make the legendary skin together with the community.
Perhaps add that to the start options?
Oh, really? Yeah. Didn't know that.
While you do that, we have another question from Cheeky. Will people be able to make a design for the community safe?
I am actually looking up, I don't know yet, and I can't answer it yet. But hopefully, yes. Oh, I know what we did wrong. Have we copied this to...
Probably not.
To the map, no. Yeah, it is here.
Yeah. Look at it. Can you look at that file again? Just open the TGA file. Yeah. And
should work. Or is this?
No, that's too wide? That's a gradient. I meant the actual.
Yeah, that's pattern. That put in the color.
Yeah, I meant the pattern file.
Let's see, like that. My bad, for doing something wrong. I don't really know what yet. The green one we have there. Red one, blue one, let's see. No, it should work as intended.
Can you go back?
Green has three different colors. Let's see what the pickup says. It's 127, it's 58, and it's 141. Did I do something wrong with the.
Check in game again. Maybe you just used the wrong pattern gradient or something.
Well, what we could do is to check another weapon I've done that I know works instead. No?
I would say fix this one.
Yeah, but I don't know what I did wrong. So, let's check in game again if it works. If it doesn't work, we go to the other skin.
Click away the audio.
And go through everything. Let's see. Skin B grade, path grade. No.
No, that's the wrong one. Go to
it's the same color. Okay, I did something wrong and I can't really explain it, so I'm gonna go to the other. We go through the Photoshop files of another skin I made, so it's easy to go through. Here we have. No, that was a sticker. Let's see. Let's go back to that folder. We open the pattern gradient. We open the pattern. And then we open the base gradient. So this skin, here's the three important files. So this skin is created by a bunch of skulls. We have done the same here. That we have the opacity on red, as you can see. You have the green, where is the color lookup from different colors. This lookup will go from this number here, as you can see. We take this color, it's 47. That would apply to that it's on here. So when you grade it, it's going to go down all the way here. The base gradient is worked on a grayscale, as you can see. You have the different materials on gray all the way. What happened then is when you go into Steam, in the game. You will get this one here, edit skin. You see the skulls, and here you have the chroma effect we talked about. You see the gray going through. This chroma effect is created by these one having, let's make it even bigger, that it goes from gray to black to gray. Again, it has an inverted.
And by gray, obviously, Yuki means white in this case.
Let's make this one. Here, in this zone here, you have an inversion that creates a silver effect moving through the gun. Okay? So, do we have any more questions? We could try to redo the pattern.
Yeah, I was a little bit busy with your skin there. So I managed to pull one here. I can't find the resource files. Where are they? So just refer to the manual.
You go to the manual. Let's see here. We go to Steam, community, the community. You go to PD2. Go to the workshop, and then you have the manual by Learn More, and you go get started. Here you go. The example files is the base gradient, the pattern, the pattern gradient, and the sticker.
Yeah, absolutely.
So do we have any more questions going on? We can try to make a new pattern. I don't know where I failed. Do you know where I failed, Toba? No, you don't.
No. What I would do is try making going into the pattern again. Something I'm guessing is perhaps it's too close to each other, so when the it decompresses a little bit.
Let's make an easier one.
Try making a bigger range of colors.
Yeah, let's try make an easier one. We do it really, really, really simple this time.
Here's a fun little question.
Yeah.
Will it's Adam too. Will Overkill release a sticker pack for people to use on their skins?
A sticker pack? No. We really want the community to create the stickers themselves. So, no, that's not something we will create. So let's make a new pattern this time and make it really simple to make it work, right?
I would say use perhaps a gradient.
Yeah,
so we can make we can see the difference.
Yeah.
Perhaps making the gradient going in a different direction than the pattern gradient.
Absolutely. So we can make it grayscale this time to make it even easier for us. So we start with 212.
Are you sure you looked at the right value, perhaps? You just
Maybe not.
Yeah.
So let's see. We have a gray box there. We have 134 here. Fill.
You should write now down the numbers. What was the first number?
And then we make a last one box here. 134 was the one. Let's see. It's a bit paint.
Okay, so give me those numbers again.
Let's see. So you have 212,
134, and the
40.
Last one was 40.
So now, actually, this one is already done for the green layer now, the color lookup. Remember you did the opacity one? We paint that white, right, Tobe?
Yeah.
White is on.
That's a tiny little brush.
Yeah, it was a tiny brush. There we go. Select inverse.
That does not look like 100% black.
You think?
No. See? Ha!
Damn, Tobbe.
Yeah, I know.
There we go. So, the red layer. Now we're doing this fast. The green layer. What was the blue layer? The blue layer is the specular.
Yeah.
Then we do like...
No, sorry, the gloss.
The gloss, of course. So, then we do it like this, this time. We take... Of course, you don't have... We take a little bit of gloss. Why doesn't it paint in it, Tobbe? Oh, because it's in the... We do like this.
Yeah.
Like that. Here we go. A little bit of gloss there. And no gloss on the outside. Right?
Yeah.
And that goes where, Tobbe?
In the blue channel.
Blue channel.
Have you set up the folders correctly?
No, not yet.
Okay. Please do that.
So we have the red one. Then we need to create the alpha channel. We can actually do a copy of this layer for that one. Then we take Control A, Control C, channels.
Oh, did you possibly like overwrite with the,
maybe.
The preview alpha on the other one? Yeah, easily happened.
Then we delete that one. Remember what we did? We did red, right?
Yeah.
Green.
Yeah.
Right.
No, that's red. Go back. Do this correctly.
I'm too stressed out now. Because we did it wrong the first time. So there we go. Now we have blue, green, red, and we put on the alpha channel. That's what we forgot last time, right? No. Save as. Target pattern new underscore one desktop save uncompressed 32 bits. Now we need to make a new. We're gonna show that gradient Tobbe was talking about.
Absolutely, yeah.
Pretty smart. We do it like that. What you do is that you take the gradient tool. You choose this one and you press it. Now we have a rainbow one. Maybe that's too obnoxious.
No. Yeah, let's do rainbow one.
So do rainbow one?
I mean, it's still you who make the skin, so it has to be a little bit ugly.
Yes.
Okay.
So you remember.
Do you want to do like a chrome effect in the other direction? Make a new layer. Just a new layer.
Oh, you mean like that? Okay.
I meant just an empty layer, but yeah, fair enough.
Oh, you mean make and rotate it and
No. Just make a black and white gradient. Basically what you have right now, but black and white. There's a preset for that.
Oh, okay, let's do it. Yeah, that one. And you want to have it way?
Yeah, going up and down.
That way?
Yeah. No, not that gradient. You used the wrong one. Sorry. Go into the presets.
Oh, you
again.
Mean the one with transparency?
That one.
That one?
Yeah, that one. That did not turn out the way I wanted it to. Okay,
oh, but it
never
works.
Mind. Yeah,
it actually works because you can do like this.
Yeah. Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a little bit hard. Can you harsh? Can you like blur that layer a little bit?
Yeah, absolutely. No, it didn't work out that good.
I meant the Gaussian blur.
Yeah, the Gaussian blur.
Yeah.
I think it should work out. Something like that?
That's nice.
Okay, so as we talked about before, if this is pixels...
Yeah, and we're definitely doing this particular pattern for Blue Nebula and his Kawaii mask. Definitely.
So you remember what we talked about before? You remember the numbers now, Tobbe? So we have...
Yes, it's
40.
212, 4,
so it should be
134 and 40.
It should be around purplish. 134 should be around this color, cyan? No,
yeah.
No. Is it called cyan?
Cyan.
Yeah.
Cyan.
And 212 should be around yellow-green here.
Yeah.
So let's save that one as well. Save as desktop. Target and path grad new. There we go. So hopefully Tobbe, this works. or we need to apply for a new job.
Well, you're the one that's doing this. I mean,
this is our M308.
I'm just picking on you.
The Patgrad new is in there.
Mm-hmm.
The Patton new is in there. Let's go back. Go into the M308. Edit skin, base skin. Skin B grad, is that my one? Yeah. Then we, this is the pattern gradient, and that should be pat grad new one.
Yeah. And moment of truth, come on now.
Pat grad new
one. No, that's gradient. You need the
pattern new one. Let's and then scale it down a bit.
Why? Look at that.
Yeah, it works. Hooray. So as you can see now, as Tobbe talked about with the effect, is that it's darkening when you scroll around. It's not that visible though, but a bit. You see it switches color on the red there, that goes white, dark. That's the thing we did with the gradient, that we put
obviously
shadows.
Obviously, if you made the vertical black lines more prominent, the effect would be more prominent.
So we can take an example here.
Blue Nebula just responded with, that is definitely a legendary skin.
Oh, thank you. So let's check out what happens if we do like this. We take this one. It's the same pattern gradient, right? We take this area.
You're gonna invert it?
We will take select, exactly. We will take no, we will actually not take that area. We'll take the mid area, like that. We will go into feather on each side, like 15. That means that we soften the edges of the selection. And we just invert it.
Yeah, see, Kaishiro 3, he definitely gets me. Yeah. He just said, well, now I believe when he said he wasn't an artist.
Save. So, now this will create. Now we have to go to pattern grid. Renew. Now you can see how it changes.
Okay, now I'm getting a bit more sold on this skin, actually. That
with the chroma effect.
Yeah.
And that's how you work with the chroma effect up and down. So in exactly this angle here, it moves to that area.
Yeah. So I got a question right now. How did the rainbow effect play into how the skin turned out? So perhaps we want to go through the step by step again on the, just showing how the color pickup works.
How this one works?
Yeah.
Or what do you mean, the rainbow effect?
Yeah, open up the files, the two files.
Oh, what happened?
That would be the pattern and the pattern.
I'm not handling computers so often, so. No. This one?
No, you're just working at the computer. Yeah. Office,
Patgrad?
Patgrad and the pattern.
And the pattern.
Yes. So, okay. So, who was it? It was Pseudodulo. Dulolo. If you take the pattern and only look at the red channel, which is the color lookup channel. So, turn off all the other channels. You have to click on the red channel. Yeah.
Like here that. We go. No,
sorry, the green channel. Yeah, so you see how these have three different kinds of gray. One of them, if we're looking at them, would be at 212.
That's 40, that's 134, and that would be...
212.
No, the opposite way, sorry. 212, 134,
yes.
And 40.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah. Absolutely correct. And those refer to the pixel values in the pattern gradient.
Going this way.
Yes.
So this is 0,
yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 255 here.
Yeah. And now you know how big Yuki thinks the pixel is.
Yeah.
So 40 pixels from the left side
here.
Would show you about which color it would pick up. And then that would be at the top of this gradient would be the looking angle
here.
Of being... Well, yeah, at the highest pixel.
Yeah, so the top would be...
When you're looking straight at it. That's
there.
Why we get these hard red colors when we're looking straight at the color.
When I pull this gun here,
yeah.
I am down to... I gotta tab out.
Yeah, roughly,
here.
Yeah, somewhere, yeah.
And then, you see, when I take this skin all the way...
Then we come there, into this other gradient
that's
further
where
down.
I'm here.
Yeah.
So it's going down all the way.
Absolutely.
On this level.
Yeah. And obviously 40 pixels is not very far from the edge. That's why the 40 square, so to speak, is very, very red. Thank you, Adam 2. See? Tobias is hilarious.
Yes, he is.
Yeah.
So how do you make a metallic effect? So imagine that we go here again.
Yeah, well,
let's actually change this.
No. What you would do here is take just...
No, we do like this. We take...
Okay, yeah.
Do we take this one. I'll go in here. We take...
Really? That many colors? You need like 3.
Let's just try it out. You see, I make... Switching colors here now. Changing up colors.
Okay, yeah, now I see what you mean.
Let's see if this works. Something like that? No? Would that be the correct one, Tobbe? Oh, sorry. Okay. We just...
Sorry, I was reading the chat.
Like that. Then we take... That is multiply. We take that area. We take this area. We do the same as we did before. The feather. 15. We invert.
Invert, yeah.
Invert it. This will be a crazy effect, I will tell you.
I just want to point out now that you see a lot of rows of black and white going over this image, but we only pick up from 3 of those lines of pixels. So it's not necessary.
As you see now, it goes back and forth.
Yeah.
It's kind of, it's shimmering and maybe not being the best example, but as you can see here, how the material is working, it's kind of decided also by gloss and specular when you're talking about doing metallic. But if you look at that spot here, how it takes up light, and it's almost like black, gold, silverish. That's how you could work with metal.
What I think we should do right now is, actually, let's do this on this yellowy color on the rifle.
Hmm?
Let's do a chrome effect on the yellow color, just to show that you can do this effect
on the base grab.
Yeah, on the rifle as well.
Let's see.
Because this effect is not limited to patterns. The same system lies for all of these
rad,
systems. So to speak.
No, I don't think I have the layers left in this one. No, but I can probably do it anyway. Yeah, we try out.
So do you want to know how to do it?
I think I know how to do it.
Oh.
Oh, you mean with this one? Then we have to create a new...
No. I meant going up and down, actually, just. So...
Let's say we... Oh, this is going to be tough. No,
no
it's
no,
not.
No. Yeah, what you want to do is... what you could do is just mark an area.
Oh, this area? But it's already gray. It's not going to work.
So. No. Yeah. Well, the gray would just make it darker on the edges. So we can actually leave that. No, not that area. That's wear and tear. Yes, it is. So you want...
The whole area? No, it's wear and tear. Is
yeah,
going from
the,
here
just
to
just the
there.
White area is fine.
No, this is the one.
Yes, so you want to mark the white area.
Okay, let's see.
So what I would do first is save this away as a channel, actually. Yeah, go to channels and save, just as a new channel, just create new channel. And fill this with white.
Okay. Tobbe is an artist, I'm not. So now it's going to happen things here. Yep.
There. Okay. Now go back to RGB actually first in the channels. There, and then go back to the layers and now create that chrome effect gradient
over the whole one?
No, over a separate on a separate image. A layer, sorry, okay. Layer. So create a new layer, then do the chrome effect over the entire picture. So just like that. Boom. Now, go back to channels. Control click on your alpha, go back to layers, and then I'm gonna point at the screen here, sorry guys. You wanna click on that icon down there that looks like a little TV thing.
The layer mask.
Yeah, there we go. Now you can choose the blending mode right there. It says normal.
Yeah, to
Like multiply. Or screen actually might be better.
Screen and then.
Multiply is better.
Multiply is better. Yeah, multiply. And change the opacity a bit, right?
Not too much, but not that's
something like that.
Yeah.
Okay. Then I need to remove your extra channel, right?
Yes, you can remove that one. Cardiac Arrestor asked, which is better, friends or payday skins? I would say payday skins with friends.
So let's save this one and see what happens. Boom, boom. Let's see. Then we need to go change this.
Thank you, Krampus.
There we go. Now you have that. If you look at this area here, as Toby was describing, do you see that it is kind of metal? If we also would have worked with the...
Now you see that the effect is what you call lesser or wider, I guess, would be one way to explain it, than on the pattern. It's because we used less of those areas.
Yeah. So depending on how much you want to tweak it, then you can actually play with glass and the cube map intensity.
Yeah.
To give it even more, what would you call it?
Yes.
Poof.
Yeah. More poof.
More explosive light, or what you would say.
No problem, Adam. Too. Yeah. Just thank you. It explains a lot.
So what you should always remember, as we talked about in all, God, I hate this, in all gradients, both pattern gradients and material gradients, is that on this length you choose, on this length it's the angle, right?
Yeah.
So on this length you choose material, boom, this is first material, second material, third material.
Yeah.
If this would be pattern, it chooses color. If this would be a pattern gradient, choose color. It's the choosing side. This way is the angle side, and would always be.
Yeah, and within each area you have the wear and tear.
Exactly.
So yeah, so can you actually open up the pattern gradient? No, the base gradient, sorry, for this weapon. Yeah, so here's a good example. So if you put the quality slider at somewhere in the middle, if you stop playing around with it, yeah, that's perfect. Can you open
that one,
exactly.
So what we have here. Yeah.
So if you make that one like really big and nice, there, and put it on the side, so we can see this the game. And yes, that's exactly what I mean, Joker. There you go. See.
Oh yeah. So the orange.
Yeah, you see the orange here in the silvery area. Click on the game so we can slide the game.
I can't move it. I hate this.
Okay, wait. Here, let me just. So if we just move this one right to the. Yeah, no. It is fine. See. So now we have. This is the area we're looking at. This silver area that goes into this bronzy color.
Yeah.
And this is this area of the gun. So at full preview quality, it has this nice silvery metally shape.
Shine,
exactly. But the more wear and tear we put into the gun, the more of this other color
the next comes color with, behind the next, it.
Yeah. Comes. So what I want you to do right now is add a second color into that brown area, just to show.
What do you mean here?
No, right here. Yeah.
Yeah. Under it.
Under it. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. To show it, then we'll take this area here. Let's see if I can mark it without fucking it up too bad.
Yes, Blue Nebula. Sometimes you just have to take control to get things done.
Exactly what his wife's done.
Huh. Well,
so we just change the saturation here. And the U to a purple to demonstrate the difference.
Well, no, don't do that. Go do it half purple, half brown. What? So you see the new edge between the two colors.
Oh, that's not what you said.
Well, yes, it was. I said okay. Add a second.
You see, I switched the color here now on the preview quality.
Yeah, so but that's not very helpful. I wanted to show that you can make a second layer underneath. Like, for example, if the base material was purple in this case, and then it had a primer of brown, and then the chrome effect on top of it. So now I'm explaining to the viewers.
Yeah, I get it. So let's see.
I know you get it.
No, I don't really. So, if we take it there, we take a gradient again, as
Sam
we did.
Gamington, yes, I'm not doing this because I was picked to read the chat, which I'm trying to do as well.
So, let's do it like this instead. Oh god, wrong one, sorry.
What?
I took the wrong one, chill out. There we go.
Uh-huh.
God, I hate that one. Save. Now, let's see. Yeah, so here we go, back there, up again. And now you see that it goes to red first and then goes into blue. So what
V45H asks how long we've been a couple.
Too long. So what it actually does is that it peels off, you could say it peels off layer by layer, pixel
exactly.
by pixel. So it goes to 1 pixel, 2 pixel, 3 pixel, and goes on, as I explained before, from right to left, left to right, sorry. It goes like this, wear and tear, wear and tear, wear and tear. Oh, now it's really crappy, and out here's the most crappy. So if you say you would have a white gun that is sprayed with white and you want it to actually look like metal underneath it, you would have to take this area here, from here to there, would be where you would put the metal.
What I meant was, it goes vertically, not
there
exactly, not in a crooked line like you could draw. So perfectly vertical at that angle.
Yeah, so white sprayed gun would have white here. Then it would go to maybe some crappy white here. And then you have metal from here to here, if you want to show that it's sprayed white on metal.
Absolutely.
Right?
Yeah.
So I think we're pretty much done. We could show,
we can now go on with the stickers.
We could show a sticker.
Yeah.
We could. I have a done stickers. I'm going to show that. No. Let's make a sticker. Let's make a sticker. So, 1024, 2024.
Mate with a skate, would give you your brain, but I am my brain, but it's unfortunately in use at the moment.
So my sticker is gonna be, let's see, what do you want to do as a sticker, Tobbe? Should I paint you?
How about we take a quick suggestion and not Ashley's Jukke Heart Tobias sticker. So anyone has a good suggestion?
More boob stickers. No, that's not
no.
That's not fair to the girls, man.
No, come on now. Made of potatoes. Yeah.
Okay, let's do something. See. Should we do one of the skulls that we have?
I'm sort of tempted to suggesting
should we do one of the skulls?
Okay,
we have them.
Yeah.
We have this amazing file we found on the internet. We're not going to steal it. We're just going to use it for educational purpose.
Yeah, actually, yeah.
Oh, I will just copy that. Control V it in here. By some reason, this is grayscale. Oh, give me a second here.
Someone suggested Almir's great beard. I'm sort
it's
of.
It's not that great anymore, is it?
No, it isn't.
Andreas?
So I actually would say, how
it
about.
It was never great.
No.
It was never great.
Oof.
Bam.
That is words from a man who doesn't have beard.
So no. But considering the collective beard power sitting behind this computer at the moment, should we give the skull a beard?
Paint a beard?
Yeah, maybe. Let's paint the beard.
Paint
Come
a
on.
Beard. Okay, so how do we do this? We do it the old-fashioned way like that. Boom, gone. Here we have sticky, guys. Sticky with white edges in the middle with soon some beard. This is what we call...
I said beard because I actually thought he would be able... That would be easy enough. I mean, there's like brushes for making beards. Like, well, not
this
beards.
This is what we
like
call a bad grass. Mustache.
Oh, come on now. There's
oh, what did I do now? Oh, it's so complicated. So, when you do a sticker, you just need to actually make a sticker like this.
Well, make the artwork, yeah.
The artwork with a transparent background. Then you need to do the alpha channel. The alpha channel has two things to consider, right? It has the opacity.
Yes.
And it has the specular.
Yes, it's actually combined in the same channel.
Yes. So.
And yes, Overkill Jones is absolutely correct. That is not a beard, that is a stubble.
Okay.
Which is a wannabe beard and doesn't count.
Okay, my bad. So we created the alpha channel here. We take this one, as usual, you control click this to mark around the whole thing. If you would have different specular and stuff in it, then you would have to do it in a different way. I create a new layer, I turn that out, I still have the marking here. We want to have that pretty, not so glossy, right?
No.
No. So if I would want to do this glossy, I would be up here. It's really glossy.
Yeah, that's super glossy.
That would actually bloom out and just be super white. So you would probably, if you want white-ish, you would be around here, right?
I'm probably actually, a bit lower. But that will still be very, very shiny.
As I said, 0 to 10 is opacity. So if you do full black, it won't be shown.
Yeah.
Up to here, if you do 8, it would be a bit invincible.
Well, it would be mostly opaque, but a little bit transparent.
So let's take 35, that we know is a good figure if you want it. Yeah. 36 is okay as well. What the fuck happened?
Oh, language.
What happened? Oh, God.
You turned off the layer.
No, it's this Photoshop. It's... I hate
it. No, what are you doing?
So, there we go. So, turn that off. We're here. We take... the paint bucket tool.
Oh God, Ashley, don't even think about it.
Select inverse. You remember we want it transparent around it, right? So we need to go down between 0 and 10. Actually 0 to make it complete. Again,
you just click, yeah.
Yeah, but that's a bug.
I don't care.
It's a bug. This is the alpha channel. The white thing here is gonna be super, super, super glossy. So if I wanna keep that or not, that's a choice.
I would...
Do you want to remove it?
Yeah.
Okay. Select, modify.
Expand
by
1 pixel.
Two,
is fine.
2 pixels, and then we just paint around it, right?
Yeah.
Oh God.
That should work.
Yeah.
Yeah. Perfect. Okay.
So control A.
What I want to do now, just to show the. Excuse me.
You want to grade it?
Yes, I do. No, not great. Sorry, go back. Can you turn on the color layer? And yes. Can you just pick something? Like the blue, the purpley flower thingies.
Mm-hmm.
And make those a little bit glossy. Just to show.
That one?
No, I want the ones. Those, yes. And also, here's a pro tip. If you hold down control while selecting something, you actually add to it and not just click on each individual pedal.
Is that control? I think you can just press that one.
No, you can't.
No, you can't. God, I hate this. So, control?
Is it shift?
No, shift move? I don't know.
Now you've done something.
I think it's just... It should add all the time.
Let me see. No, it
I think
doesn't.
I just missed and
no,
it was the tolerance.
Come on now.
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, see, there's a little plus next to it when you hold shift, which is what... Damn it.
It's the tolerance.
Yes, it's the tolerance. So,
I told you.
Kill that one.
No, it's because you're in this one.
Oh, so because someone can't...
Control D. There we go. Oh, you gotta raise the tolerance again.
There we go.
There we go. Okay.
See, you're rubbing off on me.
Okay, I know what you want to do. So there we go. Let's go back to the alpha channel again when we have these. We wanted to make something glossy, so let's make it real glossy. Something like that, Tobbe? Around 190?
Yes.
So now we did it again. Did you see that?
Yes.
I told you.
Yeah, I know.
It's a bug.
No, add it to the right layer. Come on now. Okay, now let's see.
Here we go.
It seems like I missed a few questions here.
Control A, Control C. Go to the channel we created. Control V. There we go. Layer. Throw away this layer because it's just a work layer. Oh, God.
Yeah, quote of the year. God, I hate this by Joachim. Mm, perfect.
I actually love doing skins, but I'm not a good teacher, I think. So let's save this down, right, Tobbe?
Yes.
File save as Targa, right? Always Targa, Alpha Channels, Desktop, Untitled. The name would be Untitled. As a true noob. No. So, where did we put Untitled? We put him down here. God. I hate Windows 10. Here we go. Untitled in here. So, Tobbe, where on the gun do you want to do the sticker? Because we haven't shown parts and type yet.
No. Well, I actually think... Let's do the example. So just add a sticker here and see how that turns out.
If I go to base skin.
And then go through parts and types to explain what that...
Now we gotta find it, though. Oh, yeah. I found it. Do you see that the sticker actually now applies to all different parts? That is because that's how it works on when you do it on the base. So let's just remove it again. And we go back. If I decide that I want it on the stock.
I like this comment. Joachim is trying his best to be Bob Ross. Tobias is critiquing him the whole time. Yes, yeah.
It's beautiful.
It's what I'm here for.
So now I choose. Did you all see that I chose by type, barrel, and then I choose the sticker?
Ashley is absolutely correct. I am the one with a higher voice, and Joachim is the hipster.
Thank you. Then we have the stock here. Actually, stock was the one we're going to use. We put the untitled that we were supposed to. Then we need to find it. We need to move it. We need to resize it. What I just did by putting it on the by type is that I put it here on all stocks. So if I would go out here again, save skin. I hope this works now, Tobbe. Did we fix that bug? Save skin, out. We take a stock and we move. Yeah, that place is not gonna be there probably, but let's check it out. We go in again, edit skin. I hope it works. Yeah, we have it here. Do you see, guys? So by type actually puts the sticker
in the same place for all stocks.
For all stocks.
Yeah.
But now we have a problem because this, as you can see, it doesn't work out super good. On this stock. So then you can take it one layer down. And this will override by type. So if I go by part now, I choose the stock.
Yes, miserable game dude. This is out of beta. This is not fair. You got the quest, I hate this. And I got the quote,
Oh god. So there. It shouldn't be over there.
Well, that's a big stock.
So, you see. Now I put it here on specifically this one. Because I changed by part.
Yeah.
So if I save this and go out again.
And switch around the stock, yeah.
I switch to other stock. It would, should, yes, be back. Because as it works.
Yes, Yamaha, the beta is over.
As it works, the base skin applies something. The by type would always override that for all type. That would mean all stocks override. The base, right, Tobbe?
Absolutely.
And then the part would override the type.
Yeah, so here's a tough question for you. Let's say I put a sticker on the base skin, or the base skin thing.
Yeah.
And then I go in by type.
Same.
And say, choose stock. The stock.
Yeah.
And put the sticker there. That's two different stickers. And then I go in on by type and put the sticker there, a third sticker.
No, by part.
Yeah. So, sorry.
On the stock again.
Yeah, so first base skin, sticker one. Yeah. Then by type, sticker two. Yeah. Also on the that one I choose the stock.
Yeah.
And then sticker three by type on this by part on this specific stock.
Yeah.
How many stickers? How many different stickers would I see on the gun?
Two.
Why?
Because the base skin. No. Yes, I would see two stickers because the base skin applies the sticker on all different parts. So that would be on all parts except the stock, where first the type sticker would be. But that won't be there because the by part would override the by type sticker. So you would have sticker one on all parts except the stock, where sticker three would be, because
yes,
it overrides sticker two. So you can only have one sticker.
How would you do to be able to see sticker two then?
I would would need to remove it from...
Well, you would need to change the stock.
Yes.
To a different stock.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
To a different part. Or what I could do, you could actually have up to maybe 8 or 10 different stickers. But as our game has a limited size of the skins, you could at maximum have, correct me if I'm wrong here, Tobias, but you could at maximum have 3 different stickers. That's 1024 by 1024.
Well,
but
yes,
you could have 6 of them if it would be 512 times 512.
Mm-hmm.
And you
actually more than that.
You would then actually, if you had 12 parts in the weapon,
you
would
could
be able to
have
12 of 256 times 256, right?
Well, you could have a sticker per part, yes. But that you're also limited. So you're limited by the memory space that you can dedicate to each sticker. If you have big stickers, you have less of them. But you're also limited to the number of parts on the gun, because each part, and by if you click on each
by
part here,
you see you only,
you see
have,
you only have this many
one,
parts.
Two,
that's
three, four,
six
five.
Parts in this.
Six.
Yeah, because...
Six. I told you six. Not
I'm
five.
Gonna be nice and
I
not make
five.
A comment about that.
Okay. It never happened.
Yes, Ashley, I'm crying reading the chat right now. It's yes, yeah, so you're limited to the number of parts the weapon have, and you can only have one sticker per part.
Exactly.
So there was a question by Yamaha 67. Can't you technically use the sticker method to create patterns more easily? No. That quote.
Yeah, absolutely. If you mean by not applying a pattern and you use the sticker only on the whole gun, yes, you can.
No, you can't. Well, yes, you can in theory, because, but the sticker is gonna be placed differently on different parts, and you're very limited to the amount of the size that each sticker can be. I mean, each sticker can only be 1,000 by 1,000 pixels.
Yeah, if we do like this, we take the untitled here, as we can see if we find it. There we go. I can actually... Yeah, and this is the maximum size, because I made, you see, here. But you also see that it applies differently on the different parts for the UV, so you would actually need to do one sticker for... If you want to paint the whole gun with stickers, you need to do one sticker for each part. It's going to be real difficulty, I would say. Difficult to to make a the Hype Beast in CS would be tremendously hard to do in our system, but it is doable to do a full sticker skin, or what you would call it, a custom painted skin, right?
Yeah, absolutely. That would be quite difficult due to the limitations of the sticker
system. Yes, because you would need to cut out one sticker on this part, one on this part, and one on this part, and rotate them correctly and resize them exactly.
Yeah.
Because with a UV, it also works like this, that you can see that the scale wouldn't be the exact same, right? On the on this particular gun, they're almost the same, but now you see the size here. This is the same size as this, but if you look at the barrel, the UV makes it smaller.
Yeah. However, you could apply the sticker like this, one to each part, if you wish, and then go into by type. Can you try that?
And override it.
Yeah. Well, override not the pattern, sticker in this case.
The barrel then.
Yeah. You can. No. Go back. Yeah.
steel barrel.
Yeah, because
there it goes.
Yeah, what I wanted to show is that you could have the same sticker, but override the location.
Yeah, so I could actually, let's see. Oh God, there we go.
Pseudo Dululo asks, what does UV stand for? I'm not 100% sure, but
wait a second, Per. What does UV means? We're bringing in Techie, the weapon guy that's the most...
It does not stand for ultraviolet, by the way.
Not ultraviolet either.
What you mean?
What does UV stand for in UV map?
Oh,
you don't even know either.
No, but it's...
We know what it is, but
yeah,
we don't know
it's the coordinate system.
Coordinates for the vertex positioning for textures and everything.
We have to go Wikipedia on this shit if we need to find it out.
Yes, Adam, it is the UNV axle. Bronsfield says, it is the equivalent of X and Y.
Oh, sorry.
Or longitude and latitude.
Let's go with ultraviolet. I agree.
Yeah.
Ultraviolet map.
Yeah.
Approved.
Approved.
Could you layer stickers?
No.
No, you cannot. You can only have one sticker per part.
Exactly.
Well, the thing is, Chikiki, it's a sort of term that you learn at all when studying graphics, but
I think it
means unwrap vertex. Yeah, then that
Maybe.
Makes yeah that actually makes sense because you unwrap the vertices. It makes perfect sense.
So
well, yes, there is UV flashlights, but that's a completely different kind.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
unpleasant.
It's ultraviolet, probably more than. That's the new difficulty we're talking about, the ultraviolet difficulty. So,
I started.
We missed anything? Yes, we have missed something, Tobbe.
Mm-hmm.
So, if I'm done with my skin, you can go into the screenshot here. This is what it looked like before, and you could do like this and just press screenshot. Now we actually added a feature for you that I hope you would like, that you could actually use the green screen. To just choose a color in Photoshop, delete that color, and you would have a frilagd, I don't know the English word, weapon.
I know this. Come on now.
So. You have black background. If you want, just want to do
the stream, perhaps can help me out. What is it called when you cut an image out?
So you have a few green screen screens, different colors. You have white. You have black. So let's go with this. Then you press screenshot once. If you press it like 200 times, it could be that you get the menu in. If I do like this, the menu will be in one of the screenshots probably. If you just press one, a bit simple, like this.
Yeah, something you want to keep clear of. It does take a regular screenshot of the game. So if you have a Steam pop-up, it's going to get captured, unfortunately.
Exactly. So then you take publish. You need to write a title like Ashley's birthday present. Now... we're working on your birthday present, Ashley. It's going to be something else.
Really? You said that in this...
We have a description. Here. And then you choose the screenshot. So then if you don't, you can't see it in here. So you what happens is it comes in the same folder. You can go out. You can, you know, choose which one. Oh, I think the third one is really good. What you also can do then is that you can open this one with Photoshop. Does it automatically do that now? No, of course it doesn't. So, is it control click to open with, or is it alt click?
Zachary Pratt, yes. Unlike most of you might think, I am actually married and not to Joachim.
Really? So, you can edit your screenshot, you edit it. you save it. You could do it a bit more beautiful than I did, but remember we had a tree. Then you take screenshot tree here, and you actually push the publish button. That is now locked when Steam is working. And after a while it works. Now I think, no I didn't, on this computer I don't have my overlay. Oh, Toby's girlfriend.
No.
And there you go, as you see I did the
custom. See, he can't even draw the arrow correctly, he didn't, there's no fletching on it.
Oh my bad. So, here's the custom screenshot, as you see I did. To go through a bit of marketing your skins, Steam allows GIFs, so if you want to make a GIF while you're turning your weapon around,
yeah,
for an
yeah,
instance, yeah. Or
you can add that afterwards, but you need to add one specific screenshot,
yeah,
that will be the main image of the,
yeah, so here you would add edit images and videos.
Yes, Blue Nebula, so that is not an arrow, that is actually a spear.
Yeah, it's the in-game spear.
Yeah,
I told you so. So yeah, edit images and videos for good marketing reasons if you want to market your weapon. So that was about it about this tutorial one,
yeah,
on one.
So we
will be here for
questions.
We will be here for 15 more minutes, right, Tobbe? Does that,
yeah,
work for you? Where we can take some questions.
So I have a few questions to start off here. Some of these are actually repeats of questions we had before. Venkili asks, how will you guys credit the artist of the skins? And non-Hummus asks, will the creditor of skill get accepted to the game, get a self-made copy of the skin that they made in the Steam inventory?
For the first question about the credits, we will actually create an... we're talking about creating an in-game credits for all the skin creators that would be in-game. For the second question, no, you will not get a self-made copy of the skin that you made. I'm still thinking about the fox mask for everyone. For all projects, we should get a fox mask for everyone. What do you think about fox masks?
I will get something like... what is this stereotypical artist when you have a little beret and then paint,
yeah,
splashes all over?
No, we're actually talking
about here
at the office that you get an exclusive mask if you have get a skin in game.
You can technically, yeah, that one already. And someone asked, where did I learn Photoshop actually?
In
school, yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, IT Gymnasiet. It's
oh, really?
Oh, how do you pronounce that? Translate that to English.
IT High School? Maybe?
Yes, it was a high school part. IT, I could translate. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
How will you decide which weapons get added to the safe? Ask Shikiki.
You want to go through that? I'm texting my girlfriend that I will be late.
He doesn't have a girlfriend anymore.
My okay, it's my Overwatch gang. Come on, guys. So, we are gonna look through the skins from time to time in the workshop. We're gonna choose some favorites. We have gonna have a group here at the office on some artists, some QA, a producer, and a 2D artist that would choose from the skins existing. And we would at first hand choose from the one with most votes, so it's kind of a democracy process. But as I said before, we still need to go through the files, check that it works, check that everything, all restrictions is
absolutely
right.
Absolutely,
we're gonna
have to have like rules on what you can and cannot do with the skin. We mentioned earlier stuff like using logos and brands of other companies will be a definite no-no.
Yeah.
And also offensive skins will not
yeah,
be
of course.
Accepted. Yeah. You want to pick a question somewhere?
No, you're doing this pretty good, I think.
Uh,
So what happens, I can also show you. No. Let's see. It reflects the environment. Yeah, the reflection of the environment, as we talked about before, is the cube map intensity. So if we go through the manual here, we go down to base gradient. I will show you. You see here you have the top first 6 pixels of this gradient have special attributes that read the following control. Red cube map intensity. That would be for metal, for instance, here, this one here. One of those pixels here would be the red channel. If you do that very white, it would be reflect super much of the environment. And if you do it very black on that scale from 0 to 255, so that's how you control the reflection of the environment. And that, if you want to do that on all materials in the skin, you have to do that for each. And in the template, that would be what they call the upper gradients, I think. Right, Tobbe?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think they call it upper gradients or control pixels.
Yeah, and then it says like red and green.
Yeah.
Where
there's separate folder for it.
Where the green channel would be gloss.
MarkX21 has asked the same question a couple of times now. How do I import a skin? And I'm not 100% sure what he means here. I think he means how do I import it into the game and actually use it.
Let's actually go through that.
Actually, like how you play with the game skin, and I don't.
You can't really play with the skin yet, but we could go through what we didn't do in the beginning that we maybe should have done.
Yes.
And that is that I start the game, and if I want to do a weapon, let's say for actually my favorite weapon is the Deagle. Then I will mod it as I want it. Then I take edit skin, new skin, and save skin. I don't think you have to press save skin. After you press new skin, you just have to press new skin.
Yeah.
Then I go out here.
There we go. Bev1102 asks, will the custom skins be available in game? No, they will not. The only way to use them in game, like a real skin, would be to have them accepted into the community save.
So to continue, as you see now, this was my M308 folder. As I created a new skin under that, it was created a folder named 1852 here, and that would be the Deagle. If you're insecure in which one is which one, you can open the XML file that's in it, the item EXML. And you would see, what the fuck happened there? You can see here that WeSkin, it's a Deagle in the XML file, if you're unsure. So.
Hoberox asks, will there be a legendary skin in the community save?
Yes, as we've gone through 2 times, but we can do it again if...
Not everybody heard that.
Has been around for all time. We will choose a legendary skin amongst the skins we choose from the community. And on that legendary skin, we will create a unique mod for that legendary skin and talk to the creator of the skin during that process on how we would do it and, you know, elaborate.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Potestra asks, how many skins will be chosen? Can we send in more than one skin?
You can send so many skins that you don't have time to go to your work or take a coffee with your mom. You can send 1 million skins if you
want. We do not promote spending all your time making skins and not working. That
No, we don't. No. But there is actually, I think you have a limit on how. Because when you upload skins, you upload to your cloud space, Steam cloud space, and you will have a file size limit there eventually.
Yes.
I don't know how big it is.
No, I have no idea.
I don't have a clue, but you have a limit.
Yeah.
No, we can't. Because it's actually a brand.
Yeah, I like how you just answered the question without actually reading it out.
Can you read
Shikiki,
it?
Can you please rename the Desert Eagle pistol? No, the Deagle pistol to Desert Eagle like it's supposed to be.
And we can't because it's a copyrighted brand, so it's not doable. That would be stealing their intellectual property, their copyrighted name.
Next one is... Otaku, I think. Make the skin equipable somewhere, for example in the safe house, just to try it out, see how it looks on screen, because you can't say right away if your skin looks perfect.
You can answer that, Toby. We answered it a few times.
We hope to be able to have it usable somewhere, for example the safe house, but you will not be able to use it in regular games. But that is something that might come later. It's not available at this point, no. Let's see. I think.
Do you have any more questions here?
I'm trying to pull this one. Yeah. I can't read his name. Bibigribal asks if there's a way to create skins without a program such as Photoshop.
No. You will
Will there be a way to create a skin in the program such as Photoshop and import it into the game? No, you make the skins in Payday 2. You create the files to make the skin in Photoshop.
To actually use the skins in game in Counter-Strike, I think it's a hack. Not because I tell you not to do it, but I think it's a hack, and you can only do it on bots games. But no, you won't be able either to paint directly onto the UV like you do when you do a custom paint in Counter-Strike.
Chikiki asks, will the stream be uploaded to YouTube because I want to make my friends jealous about Joachim and Tobias responding to me? Big
yes.
Smiley face.
Yes. It will most likely be up on YouTube. On the Overkill channel.
Yes. A lot of things we already answered, like how to choose skins. Tring Tong asks, will you have a workshop for masks making and put into mask safes?
It's not a project that are in line for the moment. But it's something that I personally would like to see, and if we can do it, and if we can import 3D models and find into the editor in some way, it would be really cool, and I will look into it. But it's not something that is planned at the moment, because as I said, it's a pretty big thing to be able to import 3D models.
Venkili asks, will you guys make it paintable? Make UV painting available?
No, it's not. As we set up the system, that would kind of crash the whole system. So it's not doable. If there will be a, who asked that? Can you read the question?
It's Ilasiano. Will there be a 12-day heist?
7 day? 12.
Seven, yeah, sorry.
There will not be a 7 day heist at the moment.
Will there be a 12-day heist?
Not the 12-day. we talked a lot about the 7 day heist. There are problems, people crashing, people leaving. You know, it's hard to keep it up as a heist is between 20 to 40 minutes. That times 7 is a really, really big commitment, and I don't think we're ready to do a level with that commitment yet.
The code name asks, are there possible plans to create a workshop for escape vehicle skins? Escape vehicle skins.
Who knows in the future? This is our first project with the workshop. I think we want to expand on the workshop and see more community creations, but we need to see how this goes first and see exactly how we will proceed with different workshops. As a first thing I want to do is to actually let the community create the texture of the safe and see if that could work out.
I have a question here regarding stat boosts, but he wants to contact us directly. I would prefer if you put it in the chat so we can answer it where everyone hears it.
Or you can If you really want to make it private, you can add either me or Tobias on Steam. Yeah. But
Perhaps you want to mention stat boost anyway.
Yeah, we get a lot of messages and a lot of ads, so it's not easy to reach us at all times.
Yeah, and also we're going to be away for a little while. So.
Yes, that could be actually good to say. From Friday now, we're closing the office for 2 weeks and will not be as available on Steam as we usually are. Me myself are going to look at the forums a bit, but not that much. And yes, Tobbe, I think we have a crash that we will hot fix tomorrow.
Yes, there is a crash that if you publish a skin from the workshop and then go into Steam and delete that Steam the skin from Steam and then try to republish that skin, the game will actually crash. And there's a very quick fix for that. Can you open your skin folder, please?
Yes.
So open, please, Steam. That shows your skin.
See, and if I remember where it is. Is it, let's see, Steam apps, right?
Yes, common pay to workshop.
Here,
yes.
Workshop, yep.
And click on the skin that you published.
That one?
Yes, okay, so if you open Steam, I'll show what which button I'm referring to. Can you, actually, yeah, if you delete the skin from the Steam workshop, your inventory of the Steam workshop, actually, you can show it probably.
Yeah, well, you go to workshop, your files. Do we have one?
Yeah.
And delete it. Do you know?
Delete, yeah. Delete? Yeah. If you now try to open the skin again and publish it again, it will crash.
So what do I do?
You simply remove this file, the info. Wait, give me a second. Let me just double check
it's
that.
Yeah, it's the info.
Yes, the info XML.
Like that?
That way, the game won't think that the it's skin published. Already exists on Steam and will do a full regular publish. However, this will get hot fixed, so don't worry.
And that's about it, Tobbe.
Yes.
The clock is 1 hour further than we announced the Steam to be, and now we will shut down.
Yes.
So we want to thank you all for watching. And we won't have a stream now in 2 weeks. So we'll see you in 3 or 4 weeks for the next stream.
Yeah.
Happy heisting, gamers.